वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्री जुता पदकमलं।
नाउ इन द प्रीवियस वर्स इट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन दैट नाइदर एनी material opulence nor a qualified brahmin with 12 high qualifications can satisfy the law simply by such acquisition. One can satisfy the law simply by love and devotional service. Why doesn't he not understand why so much opulence is created in erecting nice temple or churches, and so much money is expended? Does it not satisfy the Lord why they are spending so much money? The modern economy says that this is unproductive investment. Because if you construct a very big temple, just like in India we have got many temples, especially in South India, each of them is just like a fort, very big fort. There is a temple in Ranganatham, it is a few miles temple. There are 7 gates, very big temple. Many other temples. Similarly, in your country also, there are many nice churches. I have traveled all over America and have seen very big churches. Here also, in Montreal, there are many big churches. So, why they are spending so much money? Although in the modern economy still say it is non-productive investment. So, this church building or temple building or mosque building is coming down from time immemorial. People are investing their money, hard-earned money. Why? Uselessly, non-productive? No. They do not know. They do not know how much productive that is. Therefore, in this godless civilization, they have stopped building nice decorative. In Vrindavan, there is a temple of Govindaji that was 7-storied. 4 stories was broken by Aurangzeb on political grounds. Still, 3 stories are still remaining. If somebody goes there, he will see how wonderful workmanship is there in that temple. So, does it mean that those kings or rich men, they were all fools? Simply, at the present moment, we are very intelligent? No, they are not fools. That is explained in the Prahlad Maharaj's prayers. Naivatmana prabhurāva nijalābha pūrna. You cannot satisfy the Supreme Lord by constructing a nice temple, but he is satisfied. He is nijalābha pūrna. He is fully satisfied in himself. because he has no want. We are in want. Suppose I am renting one small apartment. If somebody says, Swamiji, come on, I shall construct a very nice palatial temple. Come here. Oh, I shall be very much obliged. But does Krishna or God is like that? He can construct so many nice planets, not only one, two, but millions and billions, with so many nice oceans and hills and mountains and forests and full of living entities. And why he is hankering after a temple constructed by me? No. That is not a fact.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.